might be wondering how to reconcile the desire for a long stride with the desire to have a fast cadence. Now, you can have both, and you do this by having a very powerful stride. So if you watch an elite runner and they are running really fast, they have both a very long stride and also a very fast, quick stride. In other words, they're taking many steps per minute, but those steps are also very long. Now, these elite runners get this long stride not by reaching out in front of them and overstriding, but instead by having really strong hip flexion. In other words, their hips extend far out behind their body, and their stride is long behind them rather than in front of them. If you find that your cadence is below our recommendations, it is a good idea to try to increase it slightly. Work for 30 seconds to a minute at a time during an easy run to increase your cadence. And over time, over a couple of weeks, a couple of months, that new higher cadence is going to feel a lot more manageable for you. And the reason why we're trying to increase your cadence is because it's more economical. Instead of having fewer, more impactful steps, we're going to have more frequent but less impactful steps. We're going to have less impact force with every stride that we take, and this is going to reduce a lot of those impact forces and a lot of the stress of running. If we can reduce those impact forces while making ourselves more economical in the process, then we have a win-win scenario where we're reducing our injury rate while improving our performance. If you find that you have an aggressive heel strike, it is a good idea to try to limit how often and how hard you're coming down on your heels, because this is a big injury risk. First, check your cadence. One of the most effective ways at reducing that really hard-hitting aggressive heel strike is simply by increasing your cadence. So if you have both a slower cadence and an aggressive heel strike, improving your cadence is one of the best ways to mitigate that hard heel strike. Another way to improve that hard heel strike that you might have is by really making sure that you're trying to put your foot down underneath your body. This is going to reduce overstriding, and much like taking shorter, quicker steps with trying to increase your cadence, landing underneath your body will also reduce that aggressive heel strike, because it's simply going to be much harder to really slam your heel into the ground when you're landing underneath you rather than slightly in front of you.